Hey guys, Arcanine here, and I'm going to do a quick tutorial on the creation of a beacon. Here you go. Here's a beacon, a pretty massive one. I'm going to step you through finding what is necessary to make the beacon, the battle against the Wither, and the beacon itself, and what the beacon is used for. So, join me along. First step, get into the Nether and find another fortress. So, let's go. Here we go, I found some nether fortress. I'm gonna call it nether ruins. I keep calling them nether ruins. You can tell that they're a nether fortress. It's obviously brick. It's not a natural formation, blah 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 blah. So what we're looking for is the wither skeletons. They are just like normal skeletons that you find in the normal world, except they're dark. They have black bones, and they are much taller. In fact, they may not spawn here because they cannot spawn in an area this low. They cannot walk in an area that is lower than two blocks. These people are obviously ignoring. Blazes are ignoring me because I am in creative mode. And I'm going to search for the wither skeletons. So far, when I have found them, they've actually been around blazes, which makes them very difficult to combat, because fighting a blaze who shoots fire at you and a skeleton who hits you with massive damage, it's really difficult. But again, I am in creative mode, so we're not going to deal with that right now. Is that it? Oh, there he is. So I guess this is more than two blocks. Oh, this is three blocks high. Hello? Let's compare the height difference. See? Much taller. You hitting me? Am I getting a status? Nope. Oh, he's dead. So, that was easy. Now that you've seen him, let's head back to the real world. Now, had he actually had hit me, and I actually would took damage, he would have inflicted a status effect known as Wither. And when we head back to the real world, I will explain that to you. And what we would be looking for when we kill him on the other side of the... So, if you are inflicted by a wither status effect, which is either by a wither skeleton or by the wither itself, this is really annoying me. You will be, your hearts will turn black, making it difficult to know how many health you have, and it could actually kill you. I killed myself because I didn't want to deal with that shit. The Nether was totally slowing my computer down. So what we want to do now is, while you're in the Nether, you want to pick up some soul sand. And if you kill enough of those Nether skeletons, and you're really lucky, hopefully you get to pick up some of these. Oh, pick that back up. This is how it would look like. This is a the wither head. Now let's move away from the portal. If you are inflicted by a wither status, it can kill you just like poison, and it does heal the wither. That's a little bit of a warning. The wither is not going to do any damage to me. I don't even know why I put armor on as I'm in creative mode. So the way you summon the wither is just like doing an iron golem, except the wither has three heads. Boom. Look at this dude. As his health goes up, he can't be harmed. But when his health does hit 100%, it detonates the area around him. And then he goes crazy. Everything that is not undead, the wither will attack. Except for me, because I'm in creative mode, so he ignores my existence. This dude is losing his freaking mind. Okay, let's just end his life. So why kill the wither? Well, we're trying to make a beacon, right? He has a lot of health. Assuming I wasn't in creative mode, he would be not running away from me. We would not be doing an epic battle in the sky. Oh. Are you regenerating health from me? How would you be doing that if I'm an immortal? Thank you for losing your life. Wow, me and him flew pretty high. Oh, there we go. This is what we want from him. An epic battle, which, by the way, he may be harder than the end boss, the Ender Dragon, and his stats hopefully would have been flashed on the screen while I was fighting him. There you go, Wither 2. Let's pick this up. Boom, we got the Wither Star. Now we're gonna have a lot more fun. This is when everything gets really cool and a little bit more absurd. Get the fuck out of my face. Alright. What we're gonna want is a crafting table. You know, I'll just type it here. A crafting table. We're gonna want some obsidian. We're gonna want some glass. And to do the most obscene, out of this world beacon imaginable, we're gonna want diamond. And we're gonna want a lot of diamond. We're gonna want more diamond than you could have imagined having in Minecraft. So, first thing, let's actually make the beacon. The beacon calls for 3 blocks of obsidian. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks of glass, and the Nether Star creates your beacon. Pretty simple. The beacon comes in actually 3 different sizes, and it comes in iron, gold, emerald, and diamond. Diamond being the more powerful. You can build a beacon like this. With the beacon sitting right here. And it can be higher with the beacon sitting right here, and then the beacon sitting higher and higher and higher. But we're gonna be doing the tallest one, which is actually the one which would be 1, 2, 3, 2, 3. I want you to imagine the amount of diamond that's having to be mined to make this. The amount of players needed. Okay, that's the first level. Now, obviously, you can make this in iron, but it wouldn't be as powerful. And it wouldn't be as cool. And the sun's going down, and that's not. And the sun's coming up, and it's not that cool. Who wants to put the beacon up when the sun's up? Good thing I have this thing in cheat mode. I can just freaking bring the sun back down. Okay. Alright, let's do the final level. Beacon has to be in a pyramid shape. Diamond is the most powerful. I'll say amplifier. All right, there we go. Let's set time. Time set. I don't even remember what the time would be to set night. Is that set night? Oh, that sets day. Whoa, time set. Let's double that. 4800. Oh, what? Okay. Time set zero. Oh my god. Time set night. Night. Time set 125,000. Oh wait, that is night. Okay, good. That's the moon. All right, that's cool. I thought that was the sun again. I was confused. All right. Get out of my face. You're insignificant in comparison to what we're doing. So, the beacon. All right. Look at that war zone. I don't suggest summoning the Wither near your home. Yeah. It's a good idea not to summon it near your home. Let's get it nice and dark in here. Nice and dark. Yeah. Get rid of all the light sources. Yeah, nice and dark. Good. Darkness. You know what? Let's make it darker. Oh, man. The old Minecraft darkness. When everything got really dark. And it was hard to see. You guys remember them days? I remember them days. Okay, let's do this. Bang. Tell me that's not cool. Oh, man. So, why make a beacon? Well, first of all, it looks freaking cool. It can be seen from several hundred blocks away. And at this size, from about 80 blocks away, all players will get buffs. I'm not getting any buffs. But, give me a second. There we go. This is when things get a little bit more complicated. The beacon can be charged by any of these power sources, as far as I know. And these are the different, power levels you have unlocked. The first level gives you speed and haste, increased running speed and haste. The second level gives you resistance and boost. Last level gives you strength and then regeneration if you have the highest largest pyramid, which we obviously do. So what do? Well, say we want to have higher jump, put ourselves a diamond, boom. Come on. Look at that. Tell me that's not sexy. That's cool. So what else we have? Speed. Let's put another diamond in there. Why not? And give it a few seconds. And now we're running constantly. All players within about 80 blocks of this gigantic thing will get the buff. You surround your town or your fort with these things, and you will have everyone powerful enough to defend themselves when the horde of zombies come. Get over here. Get over here. Fear it. So what's even more scarier about this? Well, I'll be right back. Dun 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 dun. Yeah. I wanted to make it more dramatic, but quite frankly, I don't have it in me. 5 beacons, actually more than 5 beacons, can be shared so long as you're able to compensate for the amount of diamond or iron or emerald or gold necessary. And with 5 beacons, this one can have speed. Sure, put a diamond in there. This one can have haste. This one can have resistance. this one can have boost. This one can have strength. And me, I can turn game mode off. How do I spell my name? Quite frankly, I do not fear the likes of you. Oh my god. You're freezing. You guys are freezing. You guys are freezing! You guys froze! You almost destroyed my beautiful temple! It's okay. The beacon is fine. The beacon is fine. Beacon is fine. Look at that. Every couple of seconds, it resets. So the time never actually runs out. As you can tell. I have all of it. Resistance to poisons, high jump, and more damage, haste. I mean, it's insane. Look at that. It's amazing. And I think this is kind of what you want your end game to be. If you guys have a server, you want this. Did you fucking blow up my temple again? What the fuck is wrong with you guys? Did I lose something? Oh, I didn't. Cool. Wow, it's pretty sturdy. Bring it on! You guys have no idea. Anyway, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this. Hope it was informative enough. Hope it wasn't that long. It is probably 30 minutes. God, I surrender. Bring it on! I will defend this to the end. Defend this to the end. God, this must be a billion diamonds piece.